We've got some great voices now just standing by to walk through what we know just so far from this huge IG report, all 500 pages. Jeff Toobin is joining us, CNN chief legal analyst and former federal prosecutor. Phil Mudd, CNN counterterrorism analyst and also former FBI and CIA. And Gloria Borger, our CNN chief political analyst. So here's what I'd like to do, guys, off the top, really, just go round robin. I want everyone's first, you know, big takeaway just from what we know so far. Jeff Toobin, starting with you.
Plenty of ammunition for both sides. If you think the FBI didn't like Hillary Clinton and didn't want to see her elected president and was biased against her, you can find that in this report. If you think that the FBI was biased against Donald Trump and there were agents there who hated him and didn't want him to win, you can find that there. It's not a good day for the FBI. It's certainly not a glowing report under either of those scenarios, but frankly, I doubt many people whose minds haven't been made up will be changed by what's disclosed today.
Gloria?
Well, I think what we're seeing in the reaction here is a very partisan reaction and predictable. You know, the Democrats are saying that Hillary Clinton was badly treated, and the Republicans are saying, you know, wait a minute, James Comey did not adhere to protocol, and therefore, the president, A, was right to fire him, and I'm sure we'll hear more about that from the president himself. And however, the inspector general could not have been more clear about the fact that he says there was no conspiracy here within the FBI, and we'll see how that plays with the president, who has said, yes, there's a conspiracy, and it has moved over to the Russia investigation.
Phil?
The other shoe didn't drop. I mean, we knew a lot of the facts here. Very poor judgment exercised, in my view, by the Attorney General, former Attorney General Loretta Lynch. Really poor judgment by James Comey. Stupid text messages between FBI participants in the investigation. We knew all that. The other shoe, which I anticipated, didn't happen. That is, the Inspector General, I thought, would come out and say, and then I saw some of this bias reflected in activities at the core of the investigation that questioned the integrity of the investigation. Didn't happen. I expected a sledgehammer. We just got the same kind of hammer you used to nail in a painting on the wall. I was surprised at how mild it was.
Well, okay, so you say mild. You also refer to those text messages as stupid. So, Phil, I just want to stay with you on that, because that was the first time we really saw the language in the text between, you know, Strzok and Page. Again, Trump's never going to become president, right? No. No, we won't. We'll stop it. I mean, how damaged, first of all, how damaged do you think law enforcement agencies are because of this coming out?
Well, I could tell you, anybody serving at the FBI, and I expect Christopher Wray, the FBI director, who's supposed to speak at 5:30 today, will address this. You cannot say that on a government phone. The point here is not that Americans, including those working at the places like the FBI, either despise Hillary Clinton or despise Donald Trump. A lot of people did. The point is, you can't exchange those messages on the phone. But you're going to go back to the question of then did the inspector general say, I saw that kind of language as pervasive enough that it affected the investigation as a whole, and he very clearly said that didn't happen.
Right, that's the question as to whether or not these two and their views clearly were emblematic of an entire agency. But you know, conservatives are going to say, how could this not be politically motivated?
Well, look, I think that that the email exchange was kind of dumb, and you know, following up on what Phil said, it shouldn't happen. It shouldn't happen. It's not as if, you know, when you serve on a jury, you're allowed to have your opinions going into a jury, but you kind of check them at the door. When you work at the FBI, you know, you're allowed to have opinions, but you check it at the door. That did not happen. But the inspector general did not take it to the next step and say that there was a conspiracy, that it was pervasive throughout the FBI, that it did affect either the Hillary Clinton investigation, or it did run over into the Russia investigation, which the president has said is rigged because these same people were investigating him. So, you know, the inspector general stopped short of doing that, but that will not stop political opponents from saying it.
Which is exactly where I wanted to go next, because we have this first press conference. We're going to see Sarah Sanders in that, you know, White House briefing room momentarily. You know, let me just go out on a limb. Everyone and assume that they're going to take this victory lap, right? We keep hearing these words, witch hunt, from the president. You know, she'll say it's justified. But I think also, Jeff Toobin, and you've been so great on this, it's so important not to conflate. You know, Comey can screw up, violate the department's norms, right, on the Hillary Clinton email investigation, but that has nothing to do with the legitimacy of the Mueller-Russia investigation.
Right, although it will be easy for Sarah Sanders and certainly the president to combine those two events. I mean, remember, one of the main issues in the Mueller investigation is, did President Trump obstruct justice by firing James Comey in order to interfere or stop the Russia investigation? The president, from the very beginning, has said, or he said a lot of different things, but the subsequent justification for firing has always been, no, I fired him because he was incompetent, because he screwed up the Hillary Clinton investigation. This report gives him ammunition to say, see, mm-hmm. James Comey deserved to be fired independent mm-hmm. of the Russia investigation.
Let me just remind everyone, I think on your point, let's remind everyone what the president has said on his firing of James Comey. Roll the sound.
But regardless of recommendation, I was going to fire Comey, knowing there was no good time to do it. And in fact, when I decided to just do it, I said to myself, I said, you know, this Russia thing with Trump and Russia is a made-up story. It's an excuse by the Democrats for having lost an election that they should have won.
That was so bad what happened originally, and it took guts for Director Comey to make the move that he made in light of the kind of opposition he had, where they're trying to protect her.
So, Toobin, I think part of your point, you know, and I want to come back to you, but that Trump can say, see, you know, thank me for firing Comey. But not only do we know he cited the Russia probe in the Lester Holt interview, and he told Russians in the Oval Office such, you saw that last clip, he praised Comey's actions during the campaign. Go ahead, Toobin, and then Gloria.
And the answer is, that was then. You know, I mean, the consistency is not something we can expect from Donald Trump. The point he will make now is, see, an independent authority said James Comey made mistakes. I fired him. I was justified in doing it.
You know, but the Democrats are going to read this report, and they're going to say James Comey made mistakes. And who did it impact the most?
Hillary Clinton.
Because of the ill-advised press conference he gave, calling her careless. Because days before the election, he decided to reopen part of the email investigation. Because he did not follow protocol with Loretta Lynch, then Attorney General. All of these things, Democrats are saying, that hurt Hillary Clinton. And by the way, the Justice Department also knew they were investigating Donald Trump at the same time, and the American public never heard about it.